Hi there, I'm Dr. Upul Wickramarachchi. I'm one of the consultant interventional cardiologists who are working in Norfolk and Norwich University Hospital in the United Kingdom. We wanted to compare the clinical outcomes at 12 months between drug-coated balloon angioplasty-treated patients and drug-eluting stent-treated patients for de novo coronary artery disease in all vessel sizes. So the design, it was a propensity score matched observational study. This was a single center retrospective study. The patient cohort is all patients, so we did not have any exclusion criterias in terms of patient or lesion characteristics. So every patient who had drug-coated balloon angioplasty to a de novo lesion, as well as and every patient who had drug-eluting stent treatment to a de novo lesion were included in the study. There was a small number of lesions where both drug-coated balloons and drug-eluting stents were used. Those lesions were excluded just because we wanted to find out the outcomes of a lesion with an implant and a lesion without an implant. And also there were a few patients who've had drug-eluting stents previously and had clinical events prior to having a drug-coated balloon, and those patients were also excluded from the drug-coated balloon arm. All other patients were included. That's the patient cohort. The endpoints were MACE, defined as a composite of all-cause death, MI, and target lesion revascularization. We also looked at the individual components of the MACE, as well as target vessel revascularization and acute vessel closure, and also definite target lesion thrombosis. Those were the endpoints. So when we did the first comparison of covariates, there was no significant difference between the cohorts in cardiogenic shock, previous coronary bypass grafts, gender, and also out-of-hospital cardiac arrest. So those four covariates were not included in the propensity score matching, as there was no difference between the two cohorts, but all the other covariates were included in the propensity score matching. So the key finding is that the MACE met MACE of drug-coated balloons met non-inferiority criteria to that of drug-eluting stents at 12 months. And there was no difference between the individual components of MACE as well. So no difference in death, all-cause death, myocardial infarction, and target lesion revascularization or target vessel revascularization. We saw a trend towards less myocardial infarction and definite lesion thrombosis in the drug-coated balloon arms. But the key findings was that the MACE of drug-coated balloon angioplasty was non-inferior to that of second-generation or newer drug-eluting stents. I think this is a useful study because this includes patients from all settings in terms of indication and lesion or patient characteristics, because it's a real world setting. And also, the evidence for drug-coated balloon angioplasty in large vessel coronaries is sparse. So this includes all the coronary all coronary vessel sizes, and actually 61% of the drug-coated balloon arm patients were treated with DCB of 3 millimeter or more, indicating that this is majority were large vessel patients. So the key finding was that the drug-coated balloon angioplasty could be used safely in all settings and in all coronary sizes with the findings that we have. The next steps, as you've seen in EuroPCR this year, there are at least two large-scale randomization trials that are planned and going to be implemented very soon, comparing this technology, the drug-coated balloon angioplasty, to the drug-eluting stent treatment in all coronary sizes. So the next steps are randomized controlled trials, and Norfolk and Norwich University Hospital is going to be part of that under the supervision of Dr. Simon Eckersall at Norfolk and Norwich. Take-home message would be that drug-coated balloon angioplasty could be a very useful tool. And in this cohort, our findings show that the treatment is non-inferior to that of drug-eluting stents in terms of major adverse cardiac events and individual clinical outcomes at 12 months, with a trend to less number of MIs and definite treated lesion thrombosis.